Welcome dear learners to massive open online course on self-learning material development. Dear learners, in this video, we will focus on systematic approach to instructional design. Because in order to design self-learning material, as a designer, we need to understand what is the concept of system approach and how it can be applied in the design and development of self-learning material. Now, why employing system approach to instruction design? As you know, in the past, plans for teaching and instruction have been largely made by intuition and have often been based upon ambiguous purposes and casual subjective judgment. And in those days, the emphasis has been with method of teaching rather than learning by the student. But soon it has been realized that instruction is a complex process. It may involve number of components and it may be affected by number of variables like individual differences among learners. There are variety of learners sitting in the traditional classroom teaching. There are variety of subjects offered in a particular course, and there are number of learning tasks or activities which are included in a course. Likewise, there are variety of instructional methods, lecture, demonstration, group discussion, so on, and media, and student evaluation is highly subjective. So, by controlling or by manipulating any one or few of the components, it will not be possible to achieve hoped for success, that is the key outcome of education, that is learning by students. So, by employing a system approach, these kind of difficulties or problems can be eliminated or reduced. Now, coming to the concept of a system, as you know, a system refers to a set of elements arranged in an orderly manner to accomplish an objective. It means a system may contain number of elements, and each element has its own function. All these elements are connected to each other, and the overall functioning of the elements would give the overall objective of the, you can say, instruction. So, taking an example from computer, it may contain input, process, output, devices. So, these are the components. It may include operating system packages, database management system, personal, for the purpose is to process data and provide information. And you will see that each of these components have a specific function. Their parts and their functions are interconnected to each other in specific ways. So, by employing systems approach, the instruction can be designed in an effective manner. So, a system comprises elements which interact with each other for a useful purpose, and we have already studied the basic input process output model with some feedback. So, system approach is applicable at various levels. It can be applied at the program level, then it can be applied at the subject level. It can also be applied on an individual topic level. Now, what are the activities which are involved while applying system approach at the program level? The first activity, you will agree with me, is the analysis of needs, goals, and priorities. So, first of all, as a designer, we have to identify or establish a need. Why there is a need for designing new instruction, or why there is a need for revising the already existing system. So, then the need has to be translated into different goals. Goals are then to be prioritized based upon the need. So, prioritization of need and goal is another very important component. The second activity which is expected of a designer of instruction is the analysis of resources and constraints. So, as a designer, you can ask few questions from yourself. Namely, how would learners learn the things that the goals specify? From whom would they learn? Where would they find resources? And what are the alternative routes to reach learning outcomes? So, the resources, their types, their quantity need to be identified and gaps are to be listed out. The third activity which is expected of a designer of instruction is for determining the scope and sequence of curriculum subjects, alternative delivery system. So, you can pick up any one subject, you can break down that subject into different topics. Different topics can be broken down to different sub-topics, etc. So, restate goals in terms of specific objectives. You can also think about whether it is to be offered on an annual basis or through semester system, what space is required, what materials, what equipments are required, and then you need to also decide about the study and evaluation scheme. Then there are few activities which are to be performed at the subject level. Firstly, determining the subject structure and sequence. So, as a designer, you need to identify the target objectives and the enabling objective. Target objective is very broad and there could be several enabling objectives which lead to the attainment of target objectives. For this, the designer would cluster all the target objectives into units. Units can be broken down into chapters, topics, subtopics, data, information, and after that a sequence can be given based upon certain principles of psychology. The next activity required of a designer of instruction is analysis of subject objectives. So, information processing analysis is to be carried out. Secondly, task classification, that is the learning outcomes, need to be stated in cognitive domain, psychomotor domain and affective domain. You may watch a video separately. And learning task analysis, that is for seeing the hierarchy, for seeing the analysis and synthesis. You can also watch a separate video on task analysis. Now, there are certain activities which are required at the lesson level. Firstly, defining performance objective or learning outcomes. So, it is a sentence or statement which describes what the learner will be able to do at the end of a unit of instruction. So, as a designer, you need to specify learning outcome and the outcomes or the performance need to be in the form of observable or measurable format and three domains, that is cognitive domain, psychomotor domain and thirdly the affective domain. The next task required of a designer of instruction is to plan for instruction. So, for each topic, e-content, learning material and lesson plans are need to be developed. Then you need to select or develop the material or the media. It may include print media, it may include non-print media, and non-print media may be included in computer assisted instruction package. Then at the lesson level, again the student performance is to be assessed and both formative evaluation and summative evaluation needs to be carried out. So, this is included in self-learning packet, that is practice task questions and feedbacks are given under formative evaluation and end module task is given as the summative evaluation. Now, there are certain activities which again are required to be carried out at the program level. Firstly, the teacher preparation. It is absolutely necessary. Teachers are required to be trained in the design and development of instructional design, for example, self-learning material, computer-assisted self-instructional material. Then formative evaluation, that is before we install this particular instructional material, we need to monitor the progress, we need to test on a small sample and see the result, and on the basis of feedback received,
the instruction system can be again revised, and finally summative evaluation is carried out. And once we receive the useful and relevant feedback from a number of formative and summative evaluation, we can say confidently, now the instructional system is quite relevant, useful, and can be installed at various levels. So, dear learner, in this video, we have learned the concept of system, the concept of system approach, and how this system approach can be applied at program level, subject level, lesson level, and how we can design the instruction, maybe self-learning material in the form of module or computer-assisted instruction, very effectively. Thank you very much.